Welcome back to STEM Talk. I'm Jess Walker, your STEMcoach.com coordinator, and today I'm here with Kylie.
Hello, my name is Kylie Howard, and I have 12 years of teaching experience, and I have also been a curriculum writer with STEMscopes.
Yeah, so Kylie was actually part of our curriculum writing summit this summer, and she worked on a really neat project that we wanted to bring to you guys today. So tell us a little bit about that project, Kylie.
Okay. I worked on Explain Communicate, and this is something new that we're adding to the curriculum. And what we are doing is adding a piece where students are required to communicate what they have learned. So we've spent a whole lot of time teaching these topics over different science concepts, and so now we want the students to talk about what they've learned, and we may have them debate or give a speech or do some type of creative project where they're required to deliver the information.
And why do you feel like it's so important for students to know how to communicate?
It's important just because it gives us another step to see what they're learning and make sure they're processing it and kind of holding them accountable for all the hard work that they've done and getting them in front of a group and able to present what they're learning is important for kiddos.
So Kylie, tell us a little bit about the process of writing these lessons.
Okay, so what we did is we took four different types of communication and decided where they best fit in K through 12. The four different types that we chose from were a debate, and with a debate it could be either a team debate or an individual debate. And we're encouraging students to really think about a topic and choose a side and decide why they chose that side. The next one we wrote to was dialogue, and this could be anything from a Socratic dialogue to an inner-outer circle or an interview. And we really want students here to talk about and be able to present to others the information and be able to ask questions and get further answers. We also wrote speech communications, and here we used four different types of speeches. We have informative, demonstrative, entertaining, and persuasive. And we decided which speech we wanted students to develop and then present to the class. The last category we chose from was creative, and this was everything else. Some lessons require students to write a song and perform it, a poem. They might design a poster or some type of diorama, and then they talk about it and they show it. And in some cases, we have them do gallery walks where they can see other people's work, or we actually have them present it and talk about why they designed it the way they did.
That's really cool. So can you tell me or kind of explain to us a little bit about what a lesson really looks like in detail?
Sure. One of the lessons that I wrote, we talked about different animals, and this was for animal needs. And in the scope, we're talking about what the basic needs of an animal. So what we did in the communicate was the students had to design a restaurant, and they would get a picture card with an animal on it, and they would have to design a restaurant for where that animal might eat. So their menu would need to include things that that animal would need to survive. And then they would take that, they would do this in a small group, and then they would take that and present it to the class. So another group would actually come to that restaurant as that animal and order it, and that group would decide, will I survive if I eat this, or am I not getting what I need from your restaurant?
That is so amazing. I love that. So, for teachers wanting to incorporate more communication in their classroom who may not have access to STEMscopes curriculum, what are some tips that you might suggest for teachers to get their students actually communicating about what they're learning?
Well, we think it's good just to get students to talk and be able to present the material, any material. It could be across the curriculum. We want students to feel comfortable in front of an audience, but we also want to teach students how to be an audience and how to be respectful of others when they are presenting or listening to a presentation. This is also a way to maybe get your shy kids that aren't comfortable talking in front of others to be able to get passionate about what they are creating and then being able to talk about it to others and kind of giving them a forum to speak to them.
Wow, that is so cool. So tell me a little bit about the benefits of having this type of communication in your classroom.
Okay, well, we know that communication is important not only in the school setting, but as they move into college and students move into the workforce. So some of the benefits would be shy kids. We really want to get those students who may not feel comfortable in front of a group and to really get them up and get them practicing how to talk in front of a group. And having these activities and this structure to it will just help them to be passionate about something. And it's so much easier to present something that we've created and that we're proud of, and be able to share that with other students. And we also need to learn as students and adults how to be in an audience and how to listen to others and be respectful of others. So this is a good place to work those in and start having those conversations of what this looks like, not only in the classroom, but in the world.
So all that being said, what are some tips you can give teachers on how to implement communication in their classroom?
Well, it's very important that we always, in any type of communication, set a structure for students. So step by step of what it might look like as they are creating and presenting their communication piece. It's also very important that you build relationships with your students and create a comfortable classroom environment where they want to share and they're not afraid to get up there and talk about what they're doing and what they've learned.
So all that being said, what are some tips you can give teachers on how to implement communication in their classroom?
Anytime we bring in a new lesson, you want to make sure you have a lot of guidelines and rules as to what it should look like while they're building it and also when they're presenting it. You also want to make sure that you're building that classroom community where they feel comfortable talking in front of others, and you're able to bring kids who are shy out of their shell just by building student and teacher relationships and letting them know that they're safe and comfortable in the classroom. For shy students, a lot of times in the past, I would have maybe let them present in a smaller group or around kids they're a little more comfortable talking with, and let them practice and kind of get comfortable with what they're doing before I just kind of throw them in and have them do it. And just making sure that they know that there's no right or wrong way, and that they can do it again, or just really get comfortable with what they're doing and know that it's a non-threatening environment for them to be able to present their thoughts.
All right. So that seems to be a challenge. What other challenges might teachers face when they're trying to implement communication? Do you have any?
Sure. I think a lot of times releasing students to do new things can be a little scary for teachers and students. So you just want to make sure that you're always the facilitator and helping them take it a step further and having those conversations when they're not quite on the right track. And again, that goes back to building those student-teacher relationships where they feel comfortable talking to you if they need guidance, and you can step in and kind of help them through it as well.
So it seems to be kind of a challenge to get the shy students out of their shells. What are some other challenges that teachers may face when they're trying to bring communication into the classroom?
That's a good question. I think that anytime we bring something new in, there's always that level of fear for both teachers and students of, will it work? How does it work? And I think ahead of time, you just want to make sure that you have a good foundation of what you want it to look like in your classroom, and then you deliver that to students. And it also goes back to building those student-teacher relationships, because you want to act as a facilitator in these situations where you can release students to work on these projects, but also be able to guide them in the direction that you think it needs to go in, and they can also feel comfortable coming to you and asking for guidance as well.
Well, Kylie, thank you so much for being here today. It was such an honor having you. And for everyone watching, if you have any questions for Kylie or for any of us about communication and how to implement it in your classroom, feel free to hit us up on Facebook or Twitter. And we'll see you next time.